Hello everybody, I'm Kazer88. Welcome back to one of my Redstone tutorial videos. I recently built this storage system here, the silo system with the indicator lights on the side, and I was asked a question if there is a way of draining items from the top chest, and the answer to that, I believe, is an item overflow system. So today I'm going to show you how to add overflow protection and detection to a chest in Minecraft. So if we look at this setup over here, then I've got a double chest, and from this double chest I've got two hoppers. I've got a hopper that is being locked. That means it's being powered by a redstone current, and so items physically cannot flow through it. And I've got one that is unlocked, which, if I was to place a chest here, it would be carrying out like normal. So that would be feeding into, for example, your item silo, your silo storage system over there. And then eventually, as it starts getting backed up, you want to be able to take items out of this chest and either do something with them or dispose of them. So many people would just throw them into a lava bucket, or the particular user, Zachary West, was asking me if, for example, if this was their coal chest, is there a way of sending the coal chest off to be used in a furnace? So if we look at what's going on here, then I've got a comparator that is looking at the chest and it's reading how many items are in that chest. I'm just using bows here in the place of using stacks, because where they're non-stackable, it's just easier than chucking 64 of an item in there. And then what that's doing, it's sending out a redstone signal in relation to how many items are in this chest. And I've got another comparator here in subtract mode, which is reading the items inside this furnace and is closing the hopper. Now, the good thing about using a furnace like this is that I can calibrate how sensitive I want this system to be by reducing the amount of items in this furnace. It means that this will start firing out items earlier, like the second a item goes in the chest. And as you've probably already seen as I was recording there, as I introduce more items into here, eventually more the power out of this circuit here overpowers the furnace, turning this comparator off, enabling items to flow through this hopper. Make sense so far? So let's take a look at what we've got at the back then. So the hopper that is currently locked by the redstone power is feeding directly into this dropper, and this dropper is powered by a redstone clock, but it's not any redstone clock, it's a redstone clock that detects if there's any items in the dropper and turns on and off, so you don't get that really really annoying constant clicking noise when there is no items in your droppers. So if I just show you now, as you can see, the comparator detects that there's an item in there, it sends out a signal which bounces back and powers the comparator. It also sends a signal round this way into the repeater, which sends another signal into here, turn this off and on again, as it were, and so that creates the blinking effect, and then as soon as there's nothing left in here, this comparator will stop sending the signal out, which breaks the loop and turns the whole circuit off. Make sense? I hope so. I'll have a quick look from this angle here. All you need is a comparator going into a block, going into a redstone dust, into a block, into a repeater, and back in. And then the second layer here, redstone dust into a block onto the back of the dropper. And this could go into either a lava source to absolutely destroy the items if you have no interest in the items, or in the case of the viewer that asked me, Zachary West, it can then go into a water stream or bubble elevator, and it can be fed into any of your other items. So how would this fit into our current storage solution that we've got over here? Well, wait right there and I will show you. And there you are, nice and easy to cover from the front. And if you look around the back, I've just everything that's new I've built in stone, and you can see all I've done is this would be the feeder chest, so this would be being fed from whatever collection systems you have for your farm or whatever your input is from above, and then it would all be going through the hopper chain into the storage silo, and this would be filling up, and then obviously eventually when it gets to the top you'd see that your silo was full. On top of that, you would know that your farm wasn't backing up and wouldn't be getting issues with lag from entities and all that sort of thing, because as this chest starts filling, this system fires, the dispenser fires off, and yeah, there's my bows down there. So yeah, that is the overflow protection system in full. I'll just pause on here for a second so that you can pause the video on this moment. It's just two comparators and a furnace and three bits of redstone dust. And then as for the disposal system, this is simply just a dropper with a redstone clock system using a comparator, a repeater, and three bits of redstone dust. Just don't forget to set the bricks up in this combination so that everything's getting powered. And that's the overflow chest from earlier, decorated and prettified, just so you don't go thinking the thumbnail was all clickbaity. That's the end of the tutorial there. If you wanted to see how the storage indicator light was built, check this video up in the top left. If you'd like to see more of me messing around playing an SMP, then check out this playlist in the top right. But yeah, until next time, love you, miss you, bye.